So I'm going to mix doubles on first. Thought it'd be nice. Something to help the fatigue.
Table 10, build 5.
Sorry about the prolonged period of silence there. I was just talking to Simon Bashir-Ashford. An unlucky dismissal in the last round. The singles. But still proud of his performance, and rightly so. Back to this. Well, I think it was, Michelle or something like that. I don't know her name. Joe on Reds. Good shot. She can double the red on the right hand side of the table if she feels more comfortable doing that. It's not the shot for now, but that's one option for her. Just taking her time with these, and rightly so. Just try and come back to about the black spot area. Didn't really get into it. The angle she potted the ball, I think she was perhaps trying to get in to the yellow and take the red to the left centre next, but she's actually landed bang on the double. She wants to take it now. And she'll be relieved to get that ball out of the way. Just went up to top table before. Have a word with Colin, who's trying to run the singles event, which is hard work, being as he's on his own up there, and he's got about a million players to get through. There's some guy up there. Would I be able to go home? I live quite close. I'll return at 1 o'clock. I've been waiting here for over an hour. Now, there's people been waiting for like 3 hours. And they're not moaning. What makes you think you're special? Prick. Anyway, there's so many people who do so much work for absolutely no thanks. It winds me up. So just trying to cover the bag. Didn't get what she wanted. As mentioned earlier, tomorrow's coverage will start 9:30-ish. That means I've got to get up. Oh, it's going to be hard work, that is. Looking forward to getting home and having a nice roast dinner. Yeah, not the best shot, that one. No real position to speak of. And if he's thinking of the double, I don't think he can get it past Ayala. Joe comes back to the table. Another chance at Reds. Has to be careful here. The path after putting this is right down towards that pocket. And she got away with it. She's going to have to play the ball to the left centre now. She play it thin. Make sure she hits the white hard enough to get it back up the table. It's going to be up and down and then maybe back up again. Oh, she had a good kiss. And she will settle for that. Hit this with confidence now, Joel. Top it through if you need to. Just make sure you get. You need some serious cue power here. It's a difficult shot. And she's played it well. She managed to hold it this side of the yellow as well. I thought she tried to play it that way. It was a good chance she might snooker herself. Just concentrate on the pot, that's all you've got to do. Great one. And then one good shot left. Well done, Joe. It's a good finish. She's happy with herself there, and rightly so. Brings it level. In this match, sisters are doing it for themselves. Two lads do their leggings. Ben Windsor must do. Oh, not Ben, Martin Windsor. I think I'm right in saying now they play a mixed doubles game. Scotch format, and then I think it's lady plays lady and man plays man. Thanks to Clive for bringing me a drink. Good on you, pal. Much appreciated. Martin to break. A good strike, but fruitless. And the team in pink. Will be the first to attack.
Hey, what's your run number?
You can see on the stream when she watches this back, Joe singing away. Very good. Look at you playing tactics. Had a go. Oh, she's got a shot at it. She can pop the yellow into the top right pocket. Gonna rely on luck though for position. It was one of them. It was always gonna be awkward. Nice effort from Ben. Wasn't easy. Interesting to see this when you've got So it's always interesting to watch these couples when they play in this game. Because you know what, women get so proud. And then afterwards, well, you said do that. Oh, no, God, pain in the arse. You end up not talking for weeks. That's why I don't let my girlfriend play pool. And she's shit, so be a waste of time. They've even asked the opposition team for some help. I think we might be explaining the concept of Scotch doubles, so pretty sure it's Scotch doubles. I've not checked actually, but they've not really got much to do here. God, it's not like they can plan the route quite so accurately. The two reds that are near the black spot. Got ball in hand as well. Why? So these two, where they were, I'd have been thinking about taking them off there because it's going to be not that easy to get good position on them. So all that thinking, and that was it. Oh God. Anyway, in fairness, best to be safe than sorry. The best thing is, he's just looked at her and gone, "You've left me shit." You're not gonna be happy. Look at him. I needed to be this side, he says. I told you they're gonna be arguing now for about a month. Holds it in, and now. In a bit of trouble. Not got much to do here. Let's go back for camera two. Watch them arguing again. What I thought was I'd leave you here rubbish so that you could come around four cushions and get on the ball into the same bag. That's just where he wanted to be. In fairness now, he's alright. If he can top this through, bring the white down. Leave it somewhere like about there. It'll be alright. Anywhere really. Even maybe a little bit further south so that he's got an angle on these two. Into the bottom right pocket. He has good options for those balls. That's what they can see live. It's brilliant viewing for them. Here we go. He's under it, that. he can't argue at the speed of the table, really. He hit the pot thick, that's why it only just went in. And it's just been ironed as a table, brushed and ironed, so shouldn't be any problem with the pace. I'm just watching the replay on a little screen here. Never had enough legs. This is probably... Oh, Welsh. Push the yellow out, but it doesn't go past the red. However, it will be on the bottom one. And you can look down the line of the screen now. That's the ball he's going to be going for. Sim kissing, making up in the side there. It's actually a bit like that situation with Sachi the other day where he's grabbed his wife by the throat. Yes, stupid. No, calm down. It's just a game. Oh, Ben's got into it too much, but left her into the top pocket. Joe's just in my way. I can't see. I can just get you on the second screen and you'll be able to see that once he moves his pink shirt out of the way. And now, ouch, just nudge the camera, and again. Right down the line of her elbow. Oof, suffering. But still, a bit awkward. You can just see that there's not quite a difficult plant to take on. Watch it. Whack into the camera. Dunk. That'd be my fault. Oh, she's gone off crying. I don't want to do that one. Well, the only shot here is the plant. At the end of the day, you know, looking at the main camera, you can see that she takes a plant, leaves the white somewhere in the middle of the table. It's not going to leave much of a shot anyway on the yellow, so take the plant on. Aim to leave the white somewhere here, and you'll be alright. Maybe you're going to be a bit further south of there, somewhere like that, and you'll be fine. Mr. Plant. Just got to cue over this yellow now. You don't want to leave too much distance between the white and the black. That's okay. She'll be pretty straight on it. Difficult to... She wants to really punch these in, but the girls, they have a tendency to try and roll them in, and it's not always the best option. Cue right through the ball. She gave it a good go there. I mean, I know she missed, but it was a committed shot. That's what you need to do. Oh, they're having a domestic. Mixed doubles has got to be one of the worst things for a relationship in the world. Playing the fudge. Here she comes, right down the line. Good shot. A little bit of distance between cue ball and object ball, but now if the I'm just looking to see if the red goes past the black into the right centre bag. If it does, you can just roll it in, not have to worry about position. and Ben missed the black completely, so that what they wanted from the shot, which was two visits, they've got. That's a good, well left plant. Martin might want to use a rest here. I think he's bemoaning his luck, he's not the tallest of players. Not an easy shot this with the rest, because you've got to get the white out. You don't want to leave it awkward. Oof, well. In the position they were in, he'd be every right to get her. Oh, it was a good effort. And she's left it safe. Just saw the replay come through on the stream, and yeah, it was very close. That's a good shot. It has left a straight double, but it's still a double. Martin landing it up pretty much dead straight. Don't fanny it in, give it a commit the shot. That's it. Oh, I thought he was going to flick off the white then and go in the other one. And this is a straightforward black. It's a tester. Pick your spot on it. The white will be coming pretty much back up and down the table in a very straight line, so that you can help use that to help you judge the potting angle. No, it's overcut it. And you heard his AQ hit the floor as he went past us. And that's a good black. Which is very happy. He's very happy with that. Now we have female team member versus female team member. Knuckle. She was never going to win anyway. Look at the touch of that one there. Touch like Gary Glitter. A few of the ladies have congregated to watch this game. The ladies singles final will be played tomorrow, apparently. Terry Bapsley against Claire Brown, I think. Pretty sure. They've made me promise that I won't put them on the TV table. I said, that's funny. I said, because the people on the chat were making me promise I would do the same thing. I gotta be honest, I watched the two semi-finals. I didn't watch Bapsi's, but I watched her before against Amanda Brown, current ladies European champion, I think. And she was brilliant, 3-0. It was about something stupid in the morning, but hey. Down the table, tight pass this yellow. She's up behind it as well. Good shot, good cueing. Of course, Joe needs to win this to take it to a deciding frame. Slightly under it, that. She's going to be coming away from the line that she needed to be on, to be on the yellow to the left centre pocket. And she's on the one now to the left centre. Still a bit of work to do here. For me, the angle, she's gone. Top it through, leave the white on the left cushion. And you can just roll the white through again. The yellow to the right centre. She's coming this way. As long as she's got a plan in her head, that's all that matters. Hampered queuing. Oh, and she's unlucky. Just caught that near knuckle. It'll take a good finish here for Joe not to come back to the table. and she's out of position on her first shot. So just a little bit of pressure getting to the girls. I'm sure it's getting to the men as well, but they're not playing at the minute. That's a magic double off the yellow, and she's back in prime position. Just run this through. 4 or 5 inches. Be a bit further on than that. That's it, perfect. Now, red into the left, right centre. Just gonna have to push this white through, because otherwise she's, oh, she's gone to the top bag. It was maybe the right shot, she had a good angle. Did whack at it though a little bit. Jo got a lot of work to do here. I think she might be, well, she's going for him. I thought she might flick off and try and leave him behind the black. Yeah, she has. She has not been 100% successful. There is a path through to the black. Oh, sorry, through to the red, nearest the blue spot. With position in mind, she'd be best playing it into the top left pocket. She tried again though. She's in the situation where she's kind of hit the ball too hard. And that one on the bottom, cautious caused the problem. You just see on the second screen here, this isn't a big bag, this middle pocket. Joe's got to roll it. That's a good shot. Oh, it looked all the way. Again, still a bit of work to do. Positionally, not that easy. And she committed to that. And it needs to roll on a little bit in no man's land, Afghanistan. Really sure what the best plan of action here. I mean, if I'm at the table, I'm going for a triple. I can hold position with the white. I can hopefully get the pot. She's going to play this. She might want to move that yellow out of the way. It's close. Has she got the pocket? No, I don't think she has. Yeah, you can see on camera too. I think that yellow goes past. That's what Joe's come around to have a look at now. If it does go past, this is now a good chance. With the sounds of slash in the background. Oh, slow. Well, This is going to be some poke now. So it's Lou's birthday. Happy birthday, Lou. Lou, the hell are you? Now for me, the shot here, she can play this yellow into the right centre. The natural angle for the white will bring it right back round the table. She's not got the pot, but she covered the ball to the left of the black. And this is going to take a good shot. Oh, she smashed it in. Somebody ring an ambulance for that pocket. And the black needs position. It's got to pull up. I think it was Michelle's just going to knock this in on her tiptoes. And there she goes. She's done well. The girls exchange handshakes. And that, I believe, puts them into the semi-finals of the mixed doubles. I'll go and have a look now what the next game we will have for you. And return shortly.
Jack Green and Teddy Lampsley, Martin McCallum.